Confused by SOX 5, HTTP, and HTTPS proxies? Never heard of UDP or TCP? If these sound like random letter combinations, don't worry. After watching this video, you'll understand these proxy protocols so well, you'll be able to explain them to others. So what is a proxy protocol? You know how a proxy acts as an intermediary between your device and the rest of the internet, right? Well, protocols define how and what type of data from your device can send to the internet via a proxy. Let's take HTTP as an example. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. It allows devices to send and receive information on the World Wide Web. So your web browser sends a request to the website server, and the server sends a response to your web browser. A major drawback of HTTP is that this protocol sends information in plain text. So anyone who wants to can intercept your message midway and read what it says. That means that basic HTTP proxies have a lot of security risks, especially if you're working with sensitive data. HTTPS proxies, however, solve this security problem. The S at the end stands for secure, and that's because HTTPS proxies use something called SSL, or Secure Sockets Layer. So even though at first glance that added S might seem insignificant, it hints to the increased reliability of HTTPS proxies. A proxy that uses the SSL layer for the HTTP protocol has two major advantages. First, it's safer than simple HTTP proxies. To keep others from reading your data, the SSL layer encrypts your connection, so its contents are never visible to third parties like internet service providers, hackers, or government institutions. Second, an HTTPS proxy is anonymous. A proxy will hide your IP, but the added safety of the SSL layer will increase your anonymity. How? It reduces the available information about your connection request. I don't know about you, but I'll take increased anonymity any day of the week. Another proxy protocol you should know is SOX. SOX proxies are usually more flexible than HTTP proxies because they work with any type of traffic. Torrents, video streaming, just to name a few examples. Meanwhile, HTTP and HTTPS were designed mainly for websites. You're most likely to encounter SOX 5, which is the current version of the protocol, hence the 5 in SOX 5. While an HTTP proxy usually supports only a protocol called TCP, SOX 5 can also use a UDP protocol. Let me explain. What the UDP protocol does is it transmits information in a more timely manner than TCP. How does it work? Well, sometimes when packets of information are being transferred onto the internet, due to occasional errors, some of the information from these packets may go missing. In such cases, the TCP protocol would reorder the missing information, but the UDP protocol wouldn't. That makes the UDP protocol faster, but it doesn't mean that all of the requested information will arrive. That's why SOX 5 proxies work best for time-sensitive uses, like video streaming or gaming. Seemingly, SOX proxies are a better choice. Are they though? Truth is, if you're going to use proxies for, let's say, web scraping, it doesn't matter which type you opt for. Since SOX works on a lower level, you'd simply be sending HTTP or HTTPS traffic over SOX. Also, a thing about SOX protocol is that it doesn't encrypt the information it sends, so SOX proxies are not as safe as HTTPS proxies. Which proxy protocols does Smart Proxy support? To put it in short, here's your answer. Check out the links below to learn more about the features of our proxies. Till next time.